The traffic was heavy and people swarmed to Donnellansbrook, Nova Scotia on Monday as the carcass of a juvenile humpback whale washed ashore, leaving people amazed and at the same time curious to what the creature looks like up close.
Oh yeah, I've never seen it before in these parts. I have seen whales before on the beach, but not, I mean, this is pretty exciting stuff for our small community here. I mean, we haven't seen this many people in Ogilvie for years, you know. It's, a high traffic area right now. I'd heard about it yesterday, and I come down with the low tide last night around 9 o'clock, and it was, of course, it was very dark. But I saw what looked to be a large rock and, kind of out of place. I'm very familiar with the beach, so it was in an odd spot. I tried to get my headlights and my truck and stuff onto it, and I went back and got a light and come down and looked, and sure enough, it was the whale. But it was very, very bitter cold, so I waited and come back this morning with the low tide, and there was hardly anybody around. I got some good pictures and stuff of, with no people and stuff around. And, of course, it's hit the media since then, so there's lots of people hanging around, but yeah.
And although it was with mixed emotions visiting the deceased whale on Monday, curiosity got the best of people as they wanted an up-close and personal view of the marine mammal.
A little bit sad, of course. I love humpback whales. They're an amazing creature. As a lot of people probably know, we have a huge herd of them, that hang around up in the Digby and the Briar Island area. And it's not common for a humpback to isolate themselves from the herd and, come down this far. And, they do see them down here, but it's not that common. And we've been seeing a humpback breach here since May of this year, which was a bit odd. And I think it's probably the same whale. I'm just guessing. I'm not a whale expert, but, that's my opinion, that it's probably the same whale that's been hanging around all year.
And Tuesday morning was no different, as crowds continued to gather and members from MARS, or the Marine Animal Response Society, were also on scene to try and figure out what happened to this whale.
It was first reported this past Sunday. It's a very fresh carcass, so it's probably died relatively recently. It's a young humpback whale. It's just under about 40 feet long. It's 13.7 meters long. From what we can see, it's most likely a male, so that would make it a young humpback. And really, we'd like to find out what the cause of death was, but that would take a full necropsy, and going to that stage takes quite a bit of resources, and there are some problems with the location and time of year as well for doing that kind of work. So today we were just doing some basic documentation, looking for signs of injury, any hint that might point to a certain cause of death. Also taking some basic measurements and also blubber thickness, which can be used as an indicator of its overall health.
And now that the testing is underway and the investigation continues, the big question is, what's next for this humpback?
We do work fairly closely with the Department of Fisheries and Oceans on these types of incidents, so we will consult with them and see what their side is saying. Moving an animal from this location, I can imagine there would be issues with that. So at this stage, I don't believe there's any plans to move it, so it may remain here for a bit, but it also will be shifting on the incoming tides as well. So depending on the wind direction, it may get blown off to a different location.
And as the Marine Animal Response Society continues their investigation here today in Donnellansbrook, the cause of death for this whale has yet to be determined, and as crowds still gather here on the beach, it's now a waiting game to see exactly what will happen with this deceased whale carcass. Reporting in Donnellansbrook, Nova Scotia, for Ian Swinimer Reports, I'm Ian Swinimer, and thanks for watching.